Hi, I'm Joe Finsternis, and tonight I'm going to be talking to you about a movie called Vampire Killers. Although in the UK the original title for this was Lesbian Vampire Killers, I guess over here in America that sounded a little too edgy. But the movie follows these two best friends, Jimmy and Fletch, and Jimmy has just gone through a breakup. Fletch has just been fired from his job, and to sort of get their mind off of things, they decide to take a trip, and stuff and things happen, and they end up having to fight off a horde of lesbian vampires. So, with an original title like Lesbian Vampire Killers, I was going into this expecting something really over the top and exploitative, and of course, I was also expecting it to be a comedy film. But as far as the sort of exploitation goes, it's pretty tame. The movie has a very stylized feel at the beginning. Like, there's this whole intro that looks like something straight out of a comic book. The colors are very saturated, with some sort of parts that are very vibrant, and it almost has a Sin City-esque aesthetic to it. And also, after that, the movie continues to feel like a comic book with a lot of this on-screen text that appears. There are these moments where characters will abruptly move in like fast motion, and it was kind of interesting to watch, but after a while, that stylized feel just completely dissipated, and it was only there for about the first 20 or so minutes of the film, so it really didn't feel like it had a point of being there in the first place. And of course, you do get to see some tits in the movie, but we have the internet. Enough said. Something that I kind of liked about this movie, though, that made it a little unique as far as vampire films go. With a lot of movies in this subgenre, there will be some involvement with Dracula in some way. But in this one, it deals with a much lesser known literary character named Carmilla, where she's the elder vampire. So I thought that was kind of cool. It made it just a little bit different from most vampire movies. Oh yeah, and as far as the comedy goes, it's okay. I mean, there were quite a few moments that made me laugh. There were very scarce, clever jokes in the movie, but overall, it was a little hit or miss for me. Also, there are some pretty decent action scenes in the movie where the characters are killing off some vampires, although it did get pretty weird. The lesbian vampires in this movie don't bleed red. For some reason, their blood is this really thick white liquid, and I'm fairly certain that it was supposed to represent semen, but the purpose behind this possible symbolism is a complete mystery to me, and there are no special features on the DVD to explain it, and frankly, I didn't care enough to Google it either. I mean, on the list of things that I have not learned about and that I should know, the possible symbolism of lesbian vampire semen blood would be way back on page 152, a few spaces above instructions on how I could safely castrate myself. Definitely one of the things that can make or break any movie is the characters, and as far as the characters in this movie go, I thought that the one who was most consistently likable throughout was the character of Jimmy. I was able to relate to him a little bit, and he had quite a few funny moments as well. In fact, he probably made me laugh more than anyone else. There's also a priest. Not a priest. Well, yeah, he has the white collar, but yeah, there's a priest in the movie who's a pretty fun character. You know, he's your standard religious vampire killer that the movie needs to have. There's also a point where he brags about the fact that he knows everything there is to know about killing vampires, and somebody points out to him, so does everyone else. So I kind of like the fact that it was poking fun at how vampire hunters are usually placed on this pedestal. As far as the character of Fletch goes, you know, I got that he was supposed to be really stupid and selfish and lazy, and he was pretty amusing for a while. I mean, the first scene he appeared in was where he was being fired from his job, and I thought that scene was really funny, but after a while, the shtick with him just really started to wear thin on me. There were quite a few jokes with him near the end of the film that had me rolling my eyes, and I was just thinking to myself, "Come on, you cannot be, you know, that fucking stupid." Easily the weakest characters in the movie were the females, though. I mean, again, it's called Lesbian Vampire Killers, at least originally. So I wasn't expecting any kind of depth from the females, but they could have at least been less annoying. Before they become vampires, the girls that Jimmy and Fletch end up meeting, for one thing, they're way too trusting. I mean, right off the bat, they're like, "Come on, get in our van. Let's go to this cottage in the middle of the woods. What could happen?" And of course, it's not really a huge mistake on their part since Jimmy and Fletcher are basically good, but I mean, they just met these guys. They should be just the least bit hesitant about that. Plus, they fucking scream a lot and they yell a lot while they're still human. There's this one girl who sees a spider, and the camera just focuses on her face as she lets out this really long scream, and it is annoying as fuck. They become a lot less annoying when they become vampires, but the vampire characters in the movie weren't very memorable at all. Even Carmilla didn't have any sort of charisma whatsoever. There's also a character in the movie named Lottie who becomes Jimmy's new love interest after the breakup, but there's really no chemistry between the characters whatsoever. I mean, she starts alluding to the fact that Jimmy might just be the one for her, and it comes right the fuck out of nowhere. Plus, they try to make her sort of a badass character, but overall, she just feels really hollow as a personality in the movie, and she offers absolutely no comedy to the picture whatsoever. She's just there to be the love interest and to kill vampires, and that's literally it. And, another thing that I wasn't quite expecting with this movie was for it to have much of a sense of realism. You know, again, lesbian vampire killers. I wasn't expecting to see a slice of life here, but there's a point where you have to suspend your disbelief so far that you would practically have to be brain dead. There's a vampire woman who gets a stick through her heart, and it's not even, you know, slightly pointed. It's actually rounded at the end in kind of a knob. And it would be like taking, you know, an old-fashioned cane with a curved end to it and shoving the curvy part through someone's chest. That's how much logical sense it makes with the way that this stick is structured. So in the end, I mean, the film had some very scarce positives going for it, but I think maybe the only way you'd have a good time with it would be if you were just drunk off of your ass and you were watching it with a group of friends, possibly. But it doesn't come recommended from me. So that's all I've got to say about Vampire Killers. I hope y'all have a good one.